he's stealing his clothes then. And I thought that's a little, might be a little bit out of order. And I think we've pretty much, we're going to get some meat off these guys. I'm going to leave it at that, I think. And then we're going to go back in and have a chat with the residents of the town. We can start off with this guy.
Fresh shower. The mainlander. Great. Fire your gun a few times and you think you're some sort of hero? This is our fight, our island, not yours.
Hey, buddy. I was just trying to help.
Charity makes you weak. Makes you need it more and more. Until you're starving from the lack of it. What happens next time when you ain't here, huh? For the next, either us harbormen survive on our own terms, or we take the long walk together. So if you're here to buy some ordnance, do your business. Otherwise, take the first boat out of here. Or the children of Adam are worse, get you.
What's your problem with the children of Adam?
We should have gunned those bastards down the moment they set foot here. Instead, we let them in. All in secret from wherever they're holed up. They've been feeding the fog. Getting it stronger. Strong enough to push us all out of our homesteads. Further and further until it's a wonder we're not all drowned in the ocean.
Do you have any proof that they've fed the fog?
Proof? Wait for that and we might as well pull the trigger ourselves. Look, my daddy's time, the fog was a nuisance. Something you avoided. Now every day it gets stronger. It's like the fires of hell out there. Because of the children.
Show me what you got.
Let's deal.
He seems very, very sure that, what's this? It's a harpoon gun. Does double damage if the target is at full health. Automatic radium gun. Interesting. They're selling cannonballs, that's pretty good. I can get like fishermen's outfits and stuff. Yeah, so it seems that those harpoon guns do quite a lot of damage, actually. It seems like this Alan guy's very, very distrustful of the, ooh, look at this lever action rifle. That's pretty cool. Fiery plasma thrower. Wow, okay. A meat hook. Yeah, cool. Well, looks like there's some pretty cool new guns you can pick up, but I might just not buy anything at the minute and then just, look at these guns. Nah, we'll probably pick some up on the way, so it seems like a bit of a 40% less action point cost. A fish catcher. Doesn't do that much less damage than my baseball bat. Why the hell not? Hey, when in Rome, use a giant fish hook. I figure we'll pick up some of those rifles and things as we go through, so best not to maybe buy it all now, but this thing we won't, so let's use this here instead of the baseball bat. That's pretty mean looking, to tell the truth. Okay.
Talk with Alan. I don't have time for you.
Oh, okay.
Sandra.
Mariner says the fog's alive. I can hear you. So mind what you say.
Shop. If you need any odds and ends, I'm your man. What's your story? Just a guy trying to make a few caps. Speaking of which, buying anything? Let's deal. Let's set you up.
See what you got then, Brooks. Okay, so he's just kind of got standard fare. Yeah. So it seems like guys in the settlement were quite prosperous. Then this kind of fog's been getting worse and worse, and they've been kind of pushed back. Recon marine helmet, eh? That's pretty cool. That's very cool. It's also 14,000 credits, which I don't have, so we'll give that a chap over here with,
You're that mainlander who just got here. Better watch yourself, because this island sees and hears everything you do. I should know. I watched the island tear down the greatest family that ever set foot in Far Harbor. It's a tale of greed, lies, and vengeance.
What family are you talking about?
I was just about to explain. My family, the Daltons, was the pride of Far Harbor for generations, even back before the war. It was lumber and fishing that made the Daltons rich, but they got greedy, took too much from the island. The island's been getting revenge ever since, killing us off one by one. I'm the last Dalton still standing. Ah! But now our story takes an unexpected turn. A mysterious stranger comes to Far Harbor. Someone strong, someone capable. With the stranger's help, the last living Dalton finally has a chance to avenge her bloodline once and for all.
Wait, are you saying that I'm the mysterious stranger who's gonna help you avenge your family?
Ah, you're a quick one. Good. You'll need your wits about you, because your part in the story is filled with danger. Now, on to the first chapter in our tale of vengeance. That would be the sad story of Freckle-Faced Petey. Petey was my cousin. He was a good lad, never caused trouble. He thought all those freckles brought him luck, but... Well, not so much. He was out foraging at the National Park campground when the island sicked some feral ghouls on him. Island's a sneaky bastard when it wants to be. Anyway, he made it back to town, but died from his injuries that night. Of course, those ferals are still out there, waiting to kill the next poor fool who comes along. Damn shame.
Where did you say these ghouls were?
National Park Campground. It's pretty much straight west of here.
Those ghouls are as good as dead.
Good, good. It's long past time those shamblers paid for what they did to Petey.
Okay. So that's pretty straightforward. She wants us to kill those, a nice outfit. Where do I get one of those? Very cool.
You did drown your troubles? The Mitch, the last plank.
Yeah, we just can see if there's anybody else out there first.
Whatever.
You could do with a haircut, to be fair. Chat with these guys.
Perfect.
No one talks to my brother, right?
Well, hello.
Okay. Fair enough. You're
Dr. Bertha. She's crazy.
Need general supplies? Visit the bait shop.
You are just a harbor woman, okay.
Every day,
let's pop into the bar. We'll go through the front then. What the hell is that? Why is there like a giant crab? Is it, it's being like cooked? Is it? That's super weird. Look at that thing. That's really weird. Okay, let's go into the last plank. That's very generous, isn't it?
Mainlander, today's your lucky day. Free beer for you.
Well, thank you.
You have anything a bit stronger?
Pushing your luck, are ya? Ha! Like it. Take this. Top shelf all around. So, wake up. Stay here over long.
special about the fog on the island?
Can't you feel it? Even here, as safe as anyone can be on this damned island. It's a lie. You walk inland and it'll blanket you up in no time. The madness will. The island will claim us all in the end.
The fog can drive you crazy?
Yes. It's not natural. The trappers you find inland, some were always murderous louts. But many just got lost in the fog for too long. And the mine goes. If you have any sense, return where you came from. And don't look back.
So yeah, why do you stay?
If it's so dangerous, why do you stay?
This is our home. If you call yourself a proper man or woman, you don't. Besides, we all gotta die. Might as well do it with your long knife deep in the belly of the beast that wrongs you. Ha!
Not interesting.
You do know what a bar's for, right?
Okay, Mitch. Well, it seems you've,
See Mitch.
Okay, Debbie, thanks.
I hope mainlanders did better than my regulars. What you need?
What do you have to drink?
All sorts of old world booze. We carry Vim, too. And before you ask, Vim is an islander favorite. We may pack more punch than the stuff you're used to.
Let's take a look at this Vim.
You got my attention.
Vim. I'll take one. Why not? Oh, whoops. I didn't actually buy it. Oh, well. Let's try again.
Excuse me.
I hope mainlanders did better than my regulars. What you need?
Let's see what you have.
Certainly.
Okay. Second try. Cool. Now then, let's have a chat here with old Longfellow.
Captain Avery said you can get me to Acadia.
Turns out with a scuffle. You get your hands dirty. I'm done leading people to their deaths. Last fella couldn't keep up.
Can you tell me about Acadia?
Strange folk. Call themselves Synths. Seems to me they just want to be left alone. Live their life in peace. They've done some good turns for the Cyclones. Fog condensers, most especially. Wouldn't even be a far harbor left without those.
What's a fog condenser?
The condensers? They're a tricky bit of science. They keep the fog away. Powered by the wind. Since fellas got up and running. Us islanders don't particularly like being obligated to that. We have.
Some parents are worried about their runaway daughter. She went to Acadia, and I need to find her.
Someone's headed for Acadia. There's always a story. Girls worth dying over, huh?
Yeah. I've done a whole lot more for a whole lot less.
Whoever you would. I could get you, but you've got to listen to me. Go where I say, when I say. Still won't be easy. You stock up on your necessities, Brad X, and when the real work can begin.
I've got loads of Rad X.
Let's go, Longfellow.
Follow me.
Notice this a little.
Hell yeah.
You've unlocked a point of interest markers across the island.
That
sweet. Okay, old Longfellow. Time for you to guide me through the fog, I guess. We'll see how it goes. I have got loads of Radix, I think. Yeah, well, right away I've got 49, so.
You need work? You might want to take this from the room.
Jerky. Okay.
Tracks. Fresh ones. Trappers here. Bullets start flying. Fine. head down if you want to do that.
Okay. So trappers are like raiders, I guess. Oh yeah, look, I can see them. Vicious, to be fair.
Yes.
I figure I should probably take their armor as it's new. But now I am over encumbered, so I need to drop something. But anything here? Yeah, we drop this. We don't need any of that. When I get a second, I'll have to chat to Nick. I think it's all that meat I've got me, actually, to be fair. Oh, is that one of them up there as well? That's a ghoul. Fog ghoul. Let's take him out. There we go. Where'd they go? Stick.
Game trails crisscross the world, so don't be surprised if we got local wildlife.
It's almost as if he's saying that and then look. Can't quite fancy it yet.
It's you or me, and it ain't gonna be me.
Basically, like the worst place to live in the world, and yet everybody's so stubborn that they just insist upon living here.
Oh, they usually stick to the deep fog. Lest we steer clear.
Let me guess, we're gonna have to find one.
The whole island is covered in fog. Fog eventually rolls by. People reset.
Kind of alive.
Someone or something else. Something else.
Okay. Oh, look, they're gonna fight amongst themselves. We're just gonna get in here with the fish hook.
they can grow 2-3 times the size of a man. Good thing we don't see too many of them.
I think gulpers are salamanders. Mr. Longfellow here. Ooh, the rats suddenly spiked around there. I must admit though, it's very pretty.
Stringing one more soul to the damnation, old man?
Well, what have we here? Another rat worshipping Lily.
Your barbs do not harm me. I am shielded by my faith.
How about bullets? Faith shield you against those two?
Let's just settle down, okay?
You're right. Waste of ammo.
Do not sully this one with your blasphemy, old man. You. I suggest you go no further. Acadia is a nest of snakes. Beasts that subvert the will of Adam.
What's Acadia done to make you distrust them?
They supply Far Harbor with the means to turn back Adam's holy fall. You'd do well to avoid such creatures, and instead, seek the only true master of this land.
Alright, I'm listening. Tell me about Adam.
Tell you? Look around. You stride through his kingdom. A land blanketed beneath sacred fog. A land Adam has claimed for his children. And you may join our faith if he deems you worthy.
Worthy? What do I have to do to join?
There is a ritual his children must perform. If you succeed, you will be rewarded with entrance into our family.
On second thought, I'm good.
So be it. But I would be mindful of where you step. After all, you are in Adam's kingdom.
You're done wasting time with a fanatic.
Well, the children of the Atom I've met before. Well, every time I've met children of the Atom, they've been pretty mental, but that's because they worship radiation. So, you can kind of understand why that might turn them a bit crazy. I guess this is Arcadia, is it?
And we've arrived. Arcadia's already been watching us for a good spell. If you want to talk with them, just go inside. They'll be waiting for you. You need my help again. You come see me. Got a cabin just outside of Far Harbor. A place to tool up and gear. It's rest. Just make sure if you bring in a bottle of something strong, there's enough to share.
Leaving already? Don't you want to see what happens next?
You say you want me to stick around and watch your back?
The thing is, I've got Nick with me, and I think I'd rather have Nick at the minute.
Maybe later.
All right. I'm serious about the offer. You ever want to hunt the forest and water and the island together? I can think of worse things.
We might pick him up for some of the side quests, actually. Because, I'd imagine that he would add a bit of colour to the island, but I think Nick's going to be good, especially chatting to the synths in there. And we just have a little look around first. It's really stunning, isn't it? I don't even know how long or how big this area is, but it looks pretty big to be fair. capture help Namorna, help Cassie Dalton. Oh, I see. Let's go and have a chat with these guys, shall we?
While you're here in Acadia, Synthkind welcomes you as long as you welcome us.
What are you?
I told you. I'm the old synth on the mountain. I know the plastic skin and tubes out the back can be unsettling, but I want to ask you to look past that. Tell me why you're here.
I came here looking for Kasumi Nakano.
Really? I'm impressed. Few would brave the kind of journey you had for the sake of someone else. Kasumi is here. She's safe and unharmed, and you're free to see her if you'd like. Before you do, though, tell me, do you think Kasumi is a synth?
We're not answering any more questions until you play straight with us. Just who the hell are you, really? There's only one synth with that kind of face and a mind of his own. And I only see him when I look in a mirror.
Nick? It can't be you.
Don't give me that. What are you trying to pull? I've never seen you before in my life.
Please, if you're willing to give me a chance, I can explain.
Is this a joke? Do you really know
me? Let me tell you what I know, and you can judge for yourself. We were prototypes, Nick. The first synths capable of independent thinking and judgment.
Keep talking.
One of the Institute's experiments had to do with how our brains could process personality. If we could handle individualized feelings and behaviors, I was allowed to develop mine based on experience. But with you, they wanted to try transferring an entire personality into you. It took several attempts before the personality imprint worked. I saw you wake up not knowing who or what you were so many times. I couldn't let them do it to you anymore. We were the only two prototypes they made. I literally saw myself in you. You were my brother, Nick. I helped you escape the Institute. We left together.
If I were your brother, I'd remember.
That's where you'd be wrong. This happened over a century ago. There's only so much memory that can fit into the prototype brains we have.
I've heard enough.
I think you and I need to talk about this. Maybe not now, though.
Is it really possible that you wouldn't remember any of this?
You mean between the Institute failsafes, beatings I've taken over the years, and plain old age? Or are you buying this whole, there's only so much room up there argument? I don't know. Not like we've got the instruction manual.
We'll talk later. This is a lot to take in.
Nick, I don't need you to believe me. I'm just glad to see you again. Whenever you're ready, I'll be here. Now, about young Kasumi. It's important that you understand exactly why she's here. I asked you before if you think she's really a synth. If you could indulge me with an answer.
Why are you asking?
Because she came here with that very question. And the answer changes every part of her world. None of us take this transition lightly. She's facing the possibility of her entire life being... being alive. That someone stripped her very identity from her and made her into something she isn't. I want you to understand that before you see her. She has a chance here to live as a synth, not hiding, not pretending to be something else. One more question, if you'll indulge me. You're here for Kasumi, but I suspect there could be another reason you came to us. Tell me, are you a synth?
No.
I'm a human being, not a synth.
Are you sure? I don't mean to question you, but what's the first memory you have?
I remember being in my house the day the bombs fell. We ran to the vault. We were frozen. I was the only survivor.
No memories before then? Just a single day, and then waking up alone? We so easily accept what's presented to us as the truth, don't we? Isn't it funny how a memory can feel like a whole different reality? People, places, even sounds and colors can change. Or someone else has changed them. I won't lie to you. There will always be other explanations. Trauma, disease, the background radiation. They all take their toll on the mind. But I can promise you that we will accept you, no matter what you decide you are.
I've heard enough. Where's Kasumi Nakano?
Of course. Kasumi is usually working down below. You can see her whenever you like. Acadia is open to you. Feel free to walk the grounds. Introduce yourself to my co-founders. Faraday and Chase, did you need anything else before you go?
So, spoilers, but the Institute's destroyed.
You should know, the Institute has been destroyed.
What? It's over? No more courser hunts? No more slavery? But that also means the technology to make the synths is lost. Our origins have been buried. Not to mention the loss of human life. Sorry. I'm not going to judge the actions of someone who's wiped out a great evil. We have our gratitude. Is there anything else you need?
Let's find his story.
What's your story?
I came to this island over a century ago, hiding from my creators, the Institute. But after my escape vault was secured, I was left with nothing. No programmed task. No false memories. I spent a year just sitting in a cave. Just sitting. One day, it finally occurred that maybe I could decide for myself what to do, who I was. I've been doing that ever since. Was there anything else?
Nothing else.
Get going.
Of course. I'm fine. You worry too much.
Sometimes I feel like you don't worry enough. You know we blew 3 more relays this week. I'm coming in. You stay right there.
Okay. Who's this? Can't seem to talk to her. You must be Faraday, I guess.
Having a hard enough time keeping up with repairs before all this nonsense with the Atom lunatics.
They're nothing you need to be concerned about.
It's not them. I'm concerned about you, Dima. You can't solve all the world's problems. Certainly not all at once.
Dearest Faraday, relax. All will be fine.
So, You've talked to Dima. You know why we're here. I certainly hope that you'll consider helping us. Dima's vision is worth fighting for.
So, you're a Sith?
I am. I hope that's not a problem for you. Dima has worked hard to create a place for us where we can be safe from those who don't accept us. He's put so much of himself into this. All his time and energy devoted to helping others. He never stops to think of himself. Sometimes I worry about... Well, if I wasn't here to make sure his equipment is all functional. And that's not even mentioning maintaining the fog condensers. So many things to keep track of.
Seems like he's lucky to have you help him.
Thank you. That's very kind.
Can you tell me about the fog condensers?
Oh, those? Dima and I designed them when it became clear the fog was only getting worse. They're effective, but have such a limited range. Dima insisted we provide them to the people of Far Harbor, and I'm so glad we did. Without the condensers, I'm not sure they'd have anywhere left.
Dima looks like he's had a lot of work done.
Well, that's certainly an understatement. Between the two of us, we've made so many modifications. He was just a prototype, never built for all this. It took a lot to overcome the limitations of the original design and expand his memory. It really is remarkable, isn't it? He's overcome so much. He's become so much more than he once was. And all he thinks of is others.
If there's anything I can do to help out, just let me know.
Well, if you're determined to help, there is something you could do. It's likely somewhat dangerous, though, so I understand if you'd rather not. There's a boat along the coast of the island. Was transporting some hardware we needed. Storage drives. The boat never finished the trip, you see. So the drives are still out there. I could really use them here for extra parts, if nothing else. My understanding is that the boat wrecked southwest of here. So, does this sound like something you could handle?
What happened to the boat? Why didn't it make it?
I'm not entirely sure, to be honest. Trappers, fog crawlers, there's no end to what's out there. What might still be out there. And the point is that we already lost someone once. I don't want to see that happen again. So, are you up for it?
Sure thing, Faraday.
No problem.
I'll get the drives for you.
Thank you. I really do appreciate it.
It's the sort of thing I'm good at, to be fair. So, to get you up to date, if you haven't played Fallout, I think I said in the last episode that synths play a large part. Now there are some synths like Nick and Dima here who are pretty early models, so you can kind of tell that they're mechanical, but then there are also synths who look completely human and it's virtually impossible to tell the difference. They're the kind of latest synths that the Institute is making. Some of them don't even know that they're synths. And it's quite the game goes into quite a lot of kind of ethical arguments about, you know, what actually makes you human or not. It's a good question, but right now we're just gonna have a little look around.
Yes.
So he hasn't actually made it kind of. Yeah, we'll take that. Hasn't actually made it clear what Dima actually wants to do. Considered doing something illegal here. They might not like that, so we won't right now. Can we talk to Chase here?
You track Kasumi here. I'm impressed. Perhaps not as quietly or efficiently as possible. But thankfully, she was never in any real danger. I'm afraid your journey was unnecessary.
I wanted to see for myself what she said.
You have my word. Acadia is a safe haven for synths. Were it not, I would not have aided anyone in reaching it. Every synth I've tracked down, every synth convinced to come here, has been assured that he or she will come to no harm. My job is to make sure they all remain safe, no matter what. Understand?
How do you manage to track down synths and bring them here?
I have a network of contacts throughout the area. Some from my time with the Institute, some after. I know the Institute's tactics. And use that to my advantage. You have Dima's blessing, so by all means, make yourself comfortable.
So So, what's your story?
I used to be a courser, returning synths that had escaped from the Institute. I was tracking a synth and instead found Dima. He convinced me of the truth and the error of my ways. I rejected the Institute, made sure they couldn't track me, and dedicated my life to instead helping synths find freedom.
Tell me about Acadia.
Dima's told you most of what you need to know. It's as safe as we can make it for now. With every new synth we rescue, we're better able to defend ourselves.
I'd like to help you. Is there anything I can do?
Actually, as a matter of fact, there is. If you're serious about contributing, well, we've got a situation I need someone to look into. You've had some experience traveling around the island, so you may be decently equipped to handle it.
What's the problem?
We were expecting a new synth to arrive, and he should have been here by now. There's been no sign of him, and I'm concerned that he might have become lost on the way here.
Do you have any leads on where he might be?
You should start by talking to Brooks in Far Harbor. He's one of us.
Oh.
A synth. He's the one who meets the new arrivals and gets them started on the journey here. Of course, he's not likely to tell you anything without proof that you're working for me. If he doesn't cooperate, tell him that his designation is L792. That should convince him. That's as much help as I can give you for now. Please, hurry. If that synth is out there alone, he won't last long.
Okay, that's fine. That's interesting, isn't it? Brooks is a synth. I wonder how many of them are synths. I had this quick theory come in my head that actually everybody in Far Harbor is a synth. Okay, look, there's a few more people down here.
I assume you're not planning on staying.
Is there a problem with my being here?
Maybe. Maybe not. Acadia is only as secure as we make it. We take unnecessary risks, we get careless, and things can go bad. Fast. If there's a synth who needs a safe place, then we take them in. Let them live as a synth, without fear. You don't fit that description. That makes you an unnecessary risk. It's nothing personal. Minimizing our contact with outsiders is just practical.
You can relax. I'm not a threat.
Just don't cause any trouble.
Okay.
Did you need something?
So you're that new fellow from the Commonwealth. It's so wonderful to meet someone from back home. I'm afraid Kasumi doesn't seem to want to discuss it, but how are things there?
You think of the Commonwealth as back home? Aren't you a synth?
Well, certainly. Why wouldn't I? It's where I came from. I would like to see it again someday, once things settle down here. Acadia is all well and good, I suppose. But honestly, it does get a bit boring.
You're safe here. That's what really matters.
I suppose. One could do with a little excitement now and then, though. Don't you think? I'm sure I'll see you around. Do take care.
New guy, right?
Look, I'm not anybody worth talking to. My head is killing me. Now's not a good time.
What's wrong?
We're doing this anyway? Even after saying I don't want to talk? God. You try having somebody botch a mind wipe on you and see how it feels. Then get back to me, okay?
I'm sorry. I didn't know.
Yeah, well, we couldn't have, so just forget it.
Okie dokie. There's somebody else in there. Seems to be quite a few of them, doesn't there?
Did you need something?
There's Mr.
So, I understand you've seen a good bit of our island. What do you think?
I actually think it is quite beautiful,
yeah. Kind of beautiful, in its own way.
That's refreshing. Most don't view it the same. I'm glad someone else can see it. This island, with all of its danger and beauty, predates you and I. The ecosystem isn't what it once was, but it has adapted, and it will continue to adapt, long after we're gone. What's important, really important in the long run, is understanding it, and then passing that knowledge along to those who will follow us.
That sounds like a noble goal.
Well, thank you. I wish more shared the sentiment. I should note that I'm not fully versed in human anatomy, but I'm your best chance of medical assistance should you require it. Since Dima has approved of you, I'm more than willing to offer help.
I'd like to help you with your research.
Oh, well, that's thoughtful of you. Okay. What can we have you do? There's a flower native to this island, a species of the genus Aster. It has survived remarkably well. It doesn't quite have the brilliance of color that I understand it once did. Before the war. I'm personally rather fond of them, but lately have been investigating secondary chemical properties they possess. If you could bring me additional samples, it would speed up my research. I could offer you a meager amount of caps, if that makes the idea more appealing.
I have some flowers for you.
I'm sorry, is this a joke I'm not in on? If you do actually find any, I'll be happy to take them.
I guess I don't actually have any. And who's this fellow?
Sounds like you got the all clear. So what's
I'm
your
guessing story? He's the mechanic.
I came here looking for Kasumi.
Oh, isn't that sweet? That Kasumi's a good enough kid, I suppose. A little confused, maybe. But then, aren't we all? Not that anyone's asking, but I'll tell you. It all gets easier to deal with when you realize none of it matters. What you are, where you came from, let go of all that, and life gets settled.
That sounds pretty bleak to me.
It's all in how you look at it. Anyway, lately I've taken to amusing myself with trading. Don't have much to work with, but I'm always happy to make a good deal. Let me know if you need something. I probably won't have it. Let me know anyway.
Let's see what you have.
You never know. I might actually have something useful.
Yes, I will take some of them, because they're for my Gauss rifle, which is probably going to come in handy. It's not like he's got anything that exciting on him. A recon marine chest piece. Some pretty heavy duty armor, and with a pretty heavy duty price tag. Shipments as well, that's pretty useful. Nice. Okay. I'll take a look at those things when. Well, don't mind if I do. Where the hell is this Kasumi then?
Acadia may not look like much from the outside.
That's Jewel, that's Miranda, that's Dejan. There's a hole in the floor. She's down there. Okay. How do I get down around here? Yes. I guess I could have just jumped down, but that might be a little bit rude.
Ugh. Circuitry is completely fried.
Is that Nick running around?
Kasumi Mikado?
Maybe if I reroute the sensors? Sorry, I'm right in the middle of something.
Your parents sent me. I want you to come home.
They did what? You came all this way for me. Look, my mom and dad, I mean, these people that were taking care of me, they wouldn't want me back. What if they knew?
What do you mean?
I'm not their daughter. I'm a sin. I thought if I just left, it would be easier for them. How would that conversation have gone anyway? I've been lying to you this whole time. Your real daughter is dead, and I replaced her?
Do you have any proof that you're actually a synth?
Little things. Dreams of waking up in a lab. Years I can't remember from when I was a kid. Not to mention how I never quite fit in back at home.
I'm not gonna try to convince her otherwise.
I know. It must be hard for you. I just want to make sure you're here for the right reasons.
Yeah, so I am. I mean, yes, I believe I'm a synth, but there's something wrong here with Acadia. There's more going on than just the refuge. I can't leave until I've gotten to the bottom of it. I done enough for you.
What kind of problem is there in Acadia?
It's a long story. I just have to figure out how to... Wait, you find things. Track down answers. That's what you do, right? That's why you came after me. What if I told you that there's a secret? A big secret here, on this island. Something way more important than just one lost girl.
What are you talking about?
Where to begin? You saw all those computers that Dima's hooked up to, right? They hold his memories, or offload data from his brain. Or maybe some combination of both? Well, Faraday asked me to help do some repairs on them, and, you know, I got curious. There's like a century's worth of life experiences in it. And that's when I see it. Data models Dima has been making. One was the fog taking over Far Harbor. Another was a nuclear detonation on the island. Plus, death counts. What if Dima is so open and welcoming because he's actually hiding something from us? A plan to wipe out the rest of the island.
You don't trust Dima? After you came all this way for him?
I didn't come to Acadia for him. I came here because this place offered answers. And now that I've found a place I belong, I'd rather not lose it all if Dima is secretly planning to destroy everything.
I'll help if I can. That's not much to go on.
I know. I've been working on that, but I haven't had much luck. I keep seeing Dima, Faraday, and Chase heading to the laboratory at the other end of the hall. Then they come out later, looking like they've been arguing. There's actually a storage space right next to there. It'd be a perfect spot to hide and eavesdrop. But it's been locked up. I've also tried breaking into Faraday's terminal, since he and Dima are so close, but the security on it is crazy.
Eavesdropping on the next meeting sounds like our best bet. Let's see if I can find a way inside that room.
Okay. Good luck, and come back as soon as you found anything.
Okay, so maybe Dima is not quite as straight up as you think. It would be a bit strange though if Dima was planning to kind of destroy the entire island, because why would he make the fog condensers? That's back up, I guess. It's down there. Is that the room they want us to go into? Yeah, it is. Oh, what's this? Storage room is for the general goods store. It's not a free-for-all. I'm not working with much to begin with, so quit taking things. You need to get in here. Come by the store. I'm going to say no. You can ask all you want, but I can, to be fair, unlock that, so that's not a problem, but I think we're going to do that in the next episode. So thank you ever so much for watching. I'll see you next time.